Okay, guys, as you see, I'm out here with my Hobie Outback. I'm in here in my basement in my what's going to be probably my new bait storage or bass cave or fishing cave or whatever you want to call it. But today we're going to do something a little different. I'm going to be talking about why I picked the Hobie Outback out of every other pedal drive that I looked at, and just going to be talking about a few of the things about each different pedal drive that really I looked at, or really that's on the market, and let you guys know what I thought of each, and maybe it'll help you guys out. Alright guys, so the main pedal drive kayaks that are on the market right now that I was looking at would be the Native Titan 12, the Pro Angler 12, the Native Slayer, the Outback, the Pescador Pilot, the Jackson Cuda, and the Hobie Compass. Now, there is now the Old Town Topwater that just came out at ICAST. I really don't care for that too much, so I don't think it would have been in my main runnings for the type of kayak I would be in, and neither for the Pelican. It's a new pedal drive that's the older model of the Hobie Outback Mirage drive, and for being the first time they made one, I don't think it's really going to be a reliable pedal drive. So then now, the top five things I looked at when buying a pedal drive is 1, speed, 2, stability, 3, storage, 4, reliability, and 5, customizable. So other than that, there were a few things I really looked at. I wanted it to be a good looking kayak too, and I wanted to be able to load it into my truck by myself. But as long as I had a landing gear or a cart like I've got for my Hobie, I don't think those two are going to be as much of an issue that's going to determine if I get a kayak. Okay guys, now I'm going to go through the list of which kayaks I look, or each of the kayaks I mentioned earlier, and the things that I liked and maybe didn't like about them. I'm not bashing any companies at all. I am just saying my opinion on what I thought of them and how my initial thoughts when I either looked at them, demoed them, or stuff that I've just seen about them or read up about them. Okay, starting off, I looked at a Jackson Cuda. I've heard that they're really good kayaks, so I looked into them. I really liked everything about it, except the speed wasn't the best. It is a bigger boat, or bigger kayak. It's heavier, so you know the speed's not going to be best. And then also, with a prop drive pedal system, you're not getting as much torque on it, so you're not going to be as much speed. Also, they didn't really have a dealer anywhere close to me where I could test one out or demo one. So without demoing it, I really didn't want to go into buying a kayak blinded or blindfolded. Next, I looked at the Pescador Pilot, the Perception Pescador Pilot, 12-foot. It wasn't a bad-looking kayak to me. It wasn't that reliable from what I've heard. Everything that I've seen is that the pedal system comes loose and it breaks, and it's not that good of a kayak to get. And for my first pedal drive kayak, if I'm spending that much money on it, I would rather get something I know is going to be reliable and something that I don't have to worry about it constantly breaking on me and when I'm out on the water. So that really was a big downfall that made me not choose it. But also, there wasn't much in-hull storage, and it wasn't fast, again, like I said with the last one. My main thing is trying to get around the big lakes pretty fast to be able to fish it and get more fishing in during the day. I couldn't do that with a paddle kayak. Okay, next is the Hobie Compass. It was fast like this Outback. It was comfortable. It was stable, really stable, because it has a lot of the same features as the Pro Angler. It really didn't have any in-hull storage. It had one center hatch like the Outback has. Other than that, you could add a square hatch on it for another $100 and then move the circle hatch up front so you had two little spots, but that's still not that much storage. And I really wanted to make sure I could store enough stuff in the kayak's hull. So that was a big downfall. Also, it was customizable, but I believe it was customizable to a point. Just because of the whole storage issue, you don't have much storage underneath to add much to. It's going to be real tight if you want to add, or if you want to add a yak power system, if you want to add a battery for your fish finder, and just stuff like that. So that was another downfall. Also, it really wasn't fishing ready or fishable from the dealer, or at least the fishable, like, of what I'm wanting, something where I can hop out, throw all my gear in it, and just take off and go catch fish. Something like that, and I believe two rod holders. I can't really hold, if it even had two rod holders, I forget. But it really, you really can't hold your rods in it, or as many as I bring. I made my crate that I have right down below me that I can hold 9 rods and all my tackle boxes in it. And then also, the seat wasn't adjustable, and it didn't have Mirage 180 drive, which was a big downfall. So, those are just the things I'm thinking. If you're, it's a really good kayak for the price, and I end up getting mine for only $50 more than what a Compass was. So I figured for $50, might as well get one that has more in-hole storage, it's more fishable right from the dealer. Okay, next, I looked at the Native Titan. I went out, I demoed it, and I wasn't that impressed with it from everything I've heard. So, putting all of my opinions aside by demoing it, this is the facts on it that I've looked up and I've found about it. But for the price of the Titan, it is a really good kayak, really reliable, but it is also a really heavy kayak. It doesn't have much in-hole storage. It has the one little spot up front, which, I mean, it is a pretty big space. Other than that, there's like nothing out through the back. So I didn't like that as much. And when I stood up in it, I actually didn't think it was that stable. I stood up, I could turn a little bit, but I felt like I constantly felt like I was gonna fall down when I was sitting or standing up in the Titan. So that was a big downfall of it too. And like I said, it's really heavy, and for the price, I wasn't impressed. And then, so yeah. Next, guys, is the Hobie Pro Angler 12. I love this kayak. It had all the storage I wanted. It was super stable. It was fishable right from the factory with every single thing you could even think of except a fish finder. And I liked the pedals with it because it had the Mirage 180 drive with turbo fins. So it still went pretty fast. So that was a pretty big contender in my option when trying to decide what kayak to get. The only thing that made me choose away from that is it's too heavy. It's over 100 pounds stock with nothing on it, and for me, it was a little bit out of my price range. I didn't feel like spending $3,000 on a used Hobie Pro Angler, or spending another $300 or $400 to get a new Pro Angler 12. So, for the price point, it was just a little out of my price range. Okay, next is one that I think is the most similar kayak to the Outback that there is on the market, and that is the Native Slayer. It has pretty much the exact same design. I believe it's about a foot longer-ish, somewhere around there, but it has the exact same type of design with front in-hole storage, the back, the little circle hatches or round hatches. It had a bunch of fishing options, and it was customizable straight from the factory. So it was right up there, just like the Outback to me. It also had enough space in it to be able to store all my tackle, like I said, how it had the front hatch. And then it did have a little bit more speed than all the other kayaks I've mentioned so far, except for the Hobie Compass. So it had more speed than the Pro Angler, just because of how heavy the Pro Angler is, but it wasn't quite as fast as the Outback. I think the Slayer goes around 4 to 4.5, maybe 5 miles per hour, and the Outback can get up to 6 with stock fins, or I think close to 7-ish with turbo fins on it. Then also, I just didn't like the pedal system. For me, having to sitting down and pedaling like a bike, it wasn't that comfortable, it wasn't that good for me. It's just something I didn't like about those. Next, I get to the Outback. It had a lot of hull storage. It didn't have quite as much as the Native Titan or as the Hobie or the Pro Angler, but I have enough storage for all my tackle. I throw my crate in the back. I can throw 9 rods and all my tackle in there. And you've got the two side pockets in here that I put the rubber upgrades on, so you can throw your scales, you can throw your fish grips, you can throw your pliers, extra baits. You've got this little, the gunnels on the side of the kayak to throw baits. They stay in there really well. It's just very customized, or you can customize this thing to the max. I think that there's so much in-hole storage that you can just keep on customizing it and not have to worry about running out of storage, which I am getting up, or I am putting some mods on it here in the next 2 weeks or so, so be ready for that. Also, it was at a better price point. Like I said, I think I got this for about $1,950, which the dealer had a sale on them. It was one of the demos versions. It was brand new. All it was stamped with demos. So I got it for a better price. But like I was saying, it has the Mirage 180 drive, so it has reverse on it, which that was a very big thing that I was looking at, is make sure it has reverse too. It wasn't one of my main five, but I love that I have reverse. Also, it is a fast kayak. Like I said, it can get almost up to 6 mph on stock fins. And with turbos, it can go almost probably up to 7. Next, the seat on it. It is super comfortable. It is a great Vantage CT seat. It has lumbar support. It's got reclining. It's got up and down settings. I really like the seat on this. So that's what's a big plus against some of the other kayaks that I looked at too. Next, it was fishable straight from the factory. Like I've been saying about each one, whether they have or haven't, this is probably the most fishable straight from the factory that I've seen a kayak so far, other than the Hobie Pro Angler. Next, like I said, comfortable seat. It is super stable to stand up in. I stood up in this thing the first time I went out on it. I didn't have one issue. It was great. So, like Skyler always tells me, it's got better primary stability than pretty much any other kayak I've tested out. So the primary stability on this thing is way better than any other kayak that there is probably out there, other than the Titan 13.5 foot or the Pro Angler. And then next, I like the design of it. I liked having the gunnels on the side. I liked being able to add the square hatch in it, having the front hatch to throw all my stuff in, the rudder system. Just everything about this really appealed to me, and I love this thing. So when I first went and took it out with the Pro Angler, this one really appealed to me for the price point. I just couldn't pass it up. Alright guys, so there you have it. There's all the different stuff about the Hobie Outback and what made me choose this. So stay tuned. I'm going on vacation this next week, and I am going to be filming a lot of ocean fishing, surf fishing. So be ready for that. It's going to be pretty sweet out there. I'll get some good footage for you guys then. And we'll see you next time, guys. Thanks for watching.